A Nord's final breath should be that of honor. Honor is what we live for. The first lesson we teach to our children. In this world, I've seen too many people who do not understand how important this word truly is. I've seen men and women trade their honor for cheap opportunity. They choose this path and lose not even a wink of sleep over it. Maybe it's because they don't want to put forth the effort. Or maybe they are tired of waiting. Maybe they don't believe in their own abilities. Whatever the reason, they have no problem abandoning honor whenever it is less profitable. For me, that is not an option. Honor runs through my veins. He's inseparable from my dragon blood and my Nord spirit. For a Nord who dies without his honor, dies with nothing, without the love and respect of his peers. Zack Stone, you like to tell stories, my friend. Well, I have a story for you. Once there was a scrawny lad. Many called him a runt, not the pick of the litter. This was a boy who looked like he could be swept away by a gust of wind. One day that small boy ventured into the hills beyond Whiterun to pick some herbs for his mother. He returned to see his home being burnt to the ground, all the crops destroyed and the livestock slaughtered, friends and neighbors dead in the streets, and his father hanging by his neck from a tree. His mother on the ground, clinging to the last bit of life, seeing that she had been defiled and gutted. He could hear the Thalmor laughing at what they had done. But his mother, in her last breath, told her son, "Don't be scared." Fast forward, that small lad is now enlisted in the Empire to fight against these Thalmor scum who took away his family. This young man befriends a Khajiit, his teacher. She taught him everything about agility. She became his family. Fast forward to a battlefield, soaked in the blood of the fallen. Everything set ablaze, as far as the eye can see. The sharp clanging of weapons, striking armor, spells soaring through the air, and exploding all around. This young man is holding his teacher, his friend, his family, in his arms, holding a wound for her as tightly as he can so the blood would stop flowing. He's calling out for a healer, pleading, but they're all dead. In her last breath, she says to him, "Don't be scared. I lost everything twice in my life. I've watched the people I love die in front of me every night since. Thoughts ran through my head. This happened because I wasn't big enough. I wasn't strong enough to save them. If I had come home earlier, maybe I could have warned my parents. Maybe if I wasn't so reckless on the battlefield, so blinded by my need for revenge, my teacher wouldn't have had to shield me from that arrow. Many years of feeling that I'm not meant to have a family. Even when I discovered who I truly was on that fateful day in Helgen. From the moment I saw the mighty Alduin land upon that watchtower, to my battle with him in Sovngarde, throughout all of that, I never tried to become close to anyone. There was Parthenax, but he was an exception. He and I understood the depths of isolation. Everyone knows my past. Even after defeating the World Eater, I never planned to settle down. I've lain with many women, but not from a place of love. It was just to feel something close for a short while before I shut myself off once again. I feared if I ever loved again, that love would be a death sentence just as before. But that has all changed since coming to this world. I found love. I found family. One shot, one kill. That is my source of power, my strength, my will to keep going forward, and never allowing my bitter past to dictate what my future may hold. You all saw the hell that we went through last year with the Order, the many times I nearly died, Carmen nearly died. But no matter what, we made sure we got back up and kept fighting. Fighting as one, fighting with the undying spirit of the King and Queen of Dragons. Now, Zack, you say that if I beat you, this could be your last match ever, that your career is pretty much dead, that I have to live with that on my conscience. Well, let me tell you one more story. The orcs, back in my home world of Nern, possess a brute force that could give us Nords a run for our money. Like the Nords, they too want to die with honor. Orc men do not wish to become frail and useless in old age, a burden to their tribes. Many older orcs seek out what they call a good death. I ran into such an orc once. Having heard of my might and prowess, he sought me out and challenged me in hopes of dying a good death. It felt wrong to cut down a mighty and honorable warrior, but it felt worse to deny him an honorable death. We fought, and when I struck the final blow, I did not see pain or suffering in his eyes. I saw the contentment and relief of a life fulfilled. He had gotten his good death. Now, Zack, I will say this. You have many, many years left in the tank. My defeating you does not have to be the end for your career. No, let it fuel you to come back stronger than ever. However, if you don't have the faith in yourself, the power of will and determination to do that, then Zack, I will give your career a good death. Zack Stone versus Claudio Dragonheart. The last ace versus the Dragon King. We will see who deserves to be the champion. We will see who deserves to be the face of Takedown. And I will see you at Redemption.